This video shows how to submit service requests in the Employee Service Center and how an agent can manage such requests. Linked timecodes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. The Employee Service Center portal provides a number of resources for employees, including an HR service catalog for making HR service requests. In our example portal, the HR service catalog is available from the Requests link here. We're logged in as Emily, who needs to request an employment verification letter for a loan. We can either review the categories to find what we're looking for, or use the search field. And here it is. We fill out the form, add any attachments if applicable, and submit our request. If we wanted to add a comment, we could do that here. Later, we can check on the status of our request from the Cases link. The new HR case opens, and we can see who the request was opened for, the subject person, and who it's assigned to. Additional people, such as a supervisor, can be added to the watch list here to receive notifications about updates to the case. We can see here in the history panel that there's been no activity since we submitted the case, so let's add a request to expedite it. Meanwhile, our HR agent, Harry, wishes to review the new cases assigned to him. We can go directly to the list of HR cases assigned to him and sort the list to view the latest cases. We can also view cases in the HR case dashboard, which provides different snapshots of all HR cases depending on how it's configured. At the top of this dashboard, we see cases that may need special attention, such as those submitted today by VIPs, unassigned cases, cases that have breached the SLA, or service level agreement, and critical cases. And here we can see how we're doing as a team. How many cases did we close today? We can sort by case state, priority, or intake method. Choosing one or more of these options filters all of the widgets on the page. But right now, we just want to look at our new cases in the ready state, listed here in My HR Cases. When we open a case, we follow the fulfillment instructions here and use the checklist of steps to systematically work the case. Per the first step, we check the history of the case in the comments and work notes, and notice that the employee asked for her request to be expedited. After reviewing the case, we're ready to work on it. So we click Start Work, which changes its state to Work in Progress. Now we need to generate the letter, verify that everything's correct, and then sign it. Generated documents may require an e-signature, which you can type or draw. The signed document is attached, so we view it for accuracy. If there was an issue, we could manage the attachments to the case via this link and rename or remove the file. Back in the checklist, we verify that we completed all the steps. Then we click Close Complete to change the state to Awaiting Acceptance. Later, logged back into the Employee Service Center as Emily, we check on the status of our request. A badge on the To-Dos link indicates that she needs to complete a task. In the To-Dos section, we can see that one task is assigned to Emily, to accept or reject the resolution provided by the HR agent. We download and check the file to make sure it's accurate. If there was an issue, we could reject the resolution, which would send the case back to the HR agent. But the file looks good, so we accept the resolution to the case. But before the case is closed, we need to enter a comment and click Accept again. If we ever need to refer back to the case, we can access it from the Cases Completed list. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.